Now let us talk about rain technology, and in this we will see the introduction of rain, goal of the technology, the architecture, the features, the advantages, the applications, the future scope, and the conclusion. And to introduce rain, you might have heard about RAID, redundant array of inexpensive disks. Now the name has some similarity, and let us see whether the workability or the functionality is also same or not. RAIN is actually the name of the original research product, and it stands for R for reliable, A for array, I for independent, N for nodes. So we have in all a reliable array of independent nodes. So the RAIN technology originated in a research project at the California Institute of Technology in collaboration with NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory and the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, that is NASA, DARPA and Caltech. This is how it came into being, and this is a component that stores data across distributed processors. Please remember, this is for data across, or storing data across distributed processors and then retrieving it even if some of the processors fail. Right, if some processor fails, then retrieval of this stored data is what RAIN is all about. And the communication component that creates this redundant network between multiple processors and supports a single uniform way of connecting to any of the processors. A computing component that automatically recovers, because we are talking about is failure. So a computing component that automatically recovers and restarts application if a processor fails. So whenever a processor fails, some action has to be taken. So RAIN does that. What are the goals of the RAIN technology, or the aim? This RAIN technology is able to offer the solution by minimizing the number of nodes in the chain connecting the client and server. First of all, it minimizes the number of nodes right from the client to the server, and RAIN technology making the exiting nodes more robust and independent of each other, or you can say an existing nodes. When there are different nodes, they are not connected, then if some node fails also, it should not hamper the action of the others. This is what RAIN technology says. So this technology provides the feature of replacing a faulty node by a healthy node. So ultimately, again, we are talking about some fault. If it is there, bypass it or replace it with healthy one. This is the architecture of RAIN, and this is a RAIN management application. These are our standard operating system which we generally use, and these are third-party applications and RAINfinity application, right? It's not Infinity, it's RAINfinity applications, and in between we have RAIN platform, global and logical monitor, always on IP, consistent global state sharing, and reliable transport. So this is how over this standard of operating system, these RAIN architecture is based. So the feature of RAIN are, once again, communication, first of all, talking between client, server, or any intermediate communication, then group membership, and the data storage. How is this fault tolerant technology comes up, like fault tolerant interconnect topology? So the problem is how to connect n, these are n, say, computing nodes in a ring of n switches. We have n computing, these are CR computing nodes, and SR switches. So how do we connect this n nodes, these computing nodes, to these in a ring of n switches? This is the fault tolerant interconnect topology. So there are some approaches. So in this approach, we connect all the nodes to the nearest switch like this. Remember, this is connected to this, this is connected to this. So these, every nearest is connected to the others, like this computing. is connected to the nearest these switches, right? A ring is one fault tolerant. This is one fault tolerant. So we can lose one switch without upset. We can lose one switch without upset. A second switch is a failure can actually partition the network, right? The problem is, or you know, the approach is, this is a ring. A ring is one fault tolerant. That means any of the switch, if it goes off, we can lose one switch without upset because others are still connected. But a second switch is failure, can partition the network. These two networks will be working differently. So here the nodes are, we are talking about diameter construction, DC2. This is D and C taken, DC equal to 2. So here the nodes are connected to switches. These nodes are connected to switches that are maximum distance apart from each other, which is diameter in the ring. See, we are making a diameter. We are making a diameter through this computing, you can say, sources. Now, diameter construction with nodes of degree 2 connected to n switches of degree 4 can tolerate 3 fault without partitioning the network, which is what is optimal, which is what is what required. So here the nodes are connected to switches that are maximum distance apart from each other, which is a diameter in a ring. This is a diameter in a ring. So this DC with nodes of degree this 2, DC equal to 2. So this has a degree of 2, means this is connected to some N switches. We have this N switches of degree say 4. This can tolerate 3 fault without partitioning. This is what we are talking about. This is optimal, right? This is optimal. This has been made when the nodes or the construction, this diameter construction is odd, and this is made when the diameter construction is even. So things are similar. And then group membership, because one of the tasks of this RAIN technology is group membership also. So the main function of group member is to tolerate the fault. Ultimately, we are talking about, you know, the failure to be replaced by healthy one, and to tolerate any fault, if at all. So the main feature of these group members is to tolerate the fault. So group member ensure that all processes maintain a consistent view of global membership. Every member, see, it has to see, you know, it has to ensure that all processes maintain a consistent view of global membership. So even if some, you know, connection is lost, this is how token mechanism is taken care. Since this is fault, okay, there is A and B connection is lost, then also these are connected. So even if this link goes down, still we are connected. This is what tolerating the fault is all about. So fault tolerance is in data storage across many disks is obtained using this redundant storage scheme. And these are novel error correcting codes that have been developed for this purpose. And these are array codes that encode and decode using simple XOR operation. Only XOR operations are required to facilitate this encoding and decoding. And what are the advantages? We have talked about it, that there is no limit on the size of the RAIN cluster. You can, you know, increase up to your requirement. And there is no concept of some master or some slave relation. RAIN cluster can tolerate multiple node failure, we just saw. And this is highly efficient in traffic management. A new node can be added into the cluster to participate in load sharing also. And it works with many different intermittent application. And the applications are, again, high availability video server, high availability web server, because here any fault is not acceptable. And also distributed checkpointing mechanism. And the future scope is, we have development of APIs for using the various building blocks. and the implementation of a real distributed file system using the partitioning scheme which is developed here, and the group communication protocols are being extended to address more challenging scenarios. So in conclusion, the goal of the RAIN project has been to build a test bed for various building blocks that address fault management. The basic idea is, if you understand after going through this video, this is actually fault management, then you will understand each and everything which I spoken. Now, communication and storage in a distributed environment, this is what is very much required in today's scenario, and the creation of such building blocks is important for the development of fully functional distributed computing system. So this is actually going to be the backbone of our functional distributed computing system. So thank you so much. Hope you understood a bit. Take care.